Stephen Dapa Addo, hyphenated Dapa Addo. Sheila Minka Premo, hyphenated. Kweku Esrefi. The practice is that the court should also observe the COVID-19 protocol. So we've decided that since this is a presidential petition, yes. Please, we put you to your election. Yes. So from Davis. That's more than you have exceeded the limit. Should be four. Yes.
Today.
That is okay. You're coming. My Lord, before that, there's a motion for live transmission as well. We believe that that should perhaps take. I'm sorry, I'm a little bit confused. You have already done the motion for. So rule that such arrangements should be based on
application to the court rather than an administrative decision. In the case of the election petition in 2012-2013, there seemed to have been an administrative decision made earlier, and then that was brought before the court itself, because presumably somebody realized that that administrative decision was not particularly appropriate. And so before the court, the matter was considered. So what I just want to understand is it that the court has decided that ahead I respectfully move in terms of our motion paper and the supporting affidavit. We are seeking my lords, it's quite clear that in the petition as filed, in a couple of places where you should have read first respondent, it went the other way. And we're seeking to make clear that, for instance, we're not asking for a runoff election between the Electoral Commission and the first respondent. That's, you know, clearly obvious. My lord, respectfully, the first and second yes, my lords. Well, lords, I looked at some 30 in your the rules of the court.
No, we want you to look at what has been filed.
What has been filed? You see,
the invocation of this court's jurisdiction, the process.
The originating process.
Is it a writ or a petition?
Not in one instance it's a writ, in another instance it's a petition.
No, you should look at it. It's not what they are saying. What do you have before you?
Well, the substance talks about a writ. A petition, sorry. Okay. Yes, that's my point.
Let's accept it and proceed with it.
That is very well.
Have you made a mistake before in life?
That is so. We all make mistakes. And that is why we believe that the petitioner should have been more kind of the innocuous errors made by the first respondent. Lord, may I make the point then that the applicant will be required to amend again certain of the statements in the proposed amendment. Yes, ma'am.
Please, you are not conducting their case
very well
for them. Well, they have gone through the process they had. They have come. And they realized that they were. So they are seeking the leave of the court to amend. Who says you can amend once?
Very well.
Oh.
I'm not going to have.
All right.
Thank you. Try two.
All rise.
Thank you.
This is a ruling court. My court. We have considered the application for me to amend the petition draft. We notice that the applicant is just seeking you to amend the petition and the appearance of the petition. We have looked at the nature of the amendment and as it does not change the nature of the petitioner's case, we grant the amendment in the 10th day. Let the amended process be found by the close of the day before 4 p.m. today. Yes, the respondents are at liberty to amend their respective answer to the petition on or before 4 p.m. tomorrow, on Friday, the 15th of January 2021. The petition is thus adjourned to Tuesday, the 19th of January 2021. The motion for live telecast of the proceedings is hereby struck at as much. Yes.
Almost quite close. And I believe that the Tuesday sitting will be the commencement of the free trial.
Yes, free trial.
Most grateful.
Allah, we are most grateful. You are most grateful to the court. Rise. Petition against the first Tuesday.
Was a harmless one. That amendment was not going to change the petition. It's the amendment.
Respecting my lords, receive number J1 plus 5.
Thank you.